Look at this. This is actually, this is brilliant. I have found a new favorite mod to play around with. Oh, oh no 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 no. Hello everybody and welcome. I'm GotToGame and this is episode number 3 of Ark Survival Evolved, and I want to play around with mods now. So I'm gonna test something. I've made my raft into a very, very hideous stone box with a ramp and a gate. Nothing's attacking me. And I've gone out to find beavers, which are there. And there's another one somewhere over there in the trees. I have a dam there, which in a minute I will use to lure them out. But first, we land here for a second. In this here storage chest and in this here feeding trough, we have stuff for taming. Meat and meadow berries. And here we have also the saddles, some I found in traps like Terror Bird Mastercraft, Sarko Mastercraft. As well as I found this in a trap as well, which I think is really, really good. Even though it's kind of really, really heavy for some reason. Ascended Fur Gauntlets. Which are pretty awesome because they actually have 62 more points armor than Flak. So yeah. Anyway. I'm gonna need these things for testing the mods I want. I've already learned the engrams, but we're gonna have a look at them. These mods are so awesome, so brilliant, so super that they literally need it in their name. We have a super spy class, a super Tranq rifle, and then here we have 25 Tranq darts. That should be enough because, well, apparently they're quite strong. Oh, first thing, you go on 7. You're gonna go on 4 for now. No, 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 no. Not the darts. The meat. I need the meat back. Come on, finish crafting up. I can't fly around like this. Too heavy. There we go. This can go back here for later. It's a metal. Pterodon does not carry a lot. But he is actually leveled up quite a bit in the meantime. Have a look. Yeah. As you see, he is at level 209. That's 5k health and almost 1200 melee damage. Actually, next level they have more than 1200. Got a few points in speed as well and a few in weight because he really was not able to carry me with Flak. Now, let's go up and look out through these mods, how they work. Where's a beaver? I know there's one somewhere around here. Are you trapped in a tree? Are you the beaver? No, you're the turtle. Ah, there's a beaver. Let's see, how does the spy class work? Does it work like the normal spy class? Actually it works a little bit. What have we got here? Stamina, food, oxygen, weight. We have everything. This guy's a male, 64. That's actually not bad. Got his health, his torpor. That's pretty good. Let's have a look at the other one over here. Where is it? Where is it? Well, I'm guessing we're gonna have to debate that over the beaver now. Anyway, let's go land you. Here. Let's see. This guy. And this guy. I attempted up this guy when I was parking my boat around. Actually, level. Just giving him health. Then we're gonna die with one hit of anything. Now, first things first. Let's whistle passive. Passive. Then we want to test this. A weapon. A yonder. And I think I need to get a door in here, maybe. Or in here because, well, this is very impractical. Let's see. No, nothing attacking me. That's a good start. That's a very, very good start. Dun dun. Dun dun. Ta-da. Dun dun. Anything attacks me, anyway, just gonna run away. Now, where's the beaver? We had located one just over here. You. There's two of them. You know what? No, no, no. This has to be close. And I have stuff coming in, killing everything. You, come with me. I need you quickly to just take care of this guy. And this guy. No. Yeah. Well, great. Epic failure. No. There we go. This is what we can land safely for now. A rock. Up, dum, dum. Dum, dum. Better now. Bum, bum. Where is he? Okay. I'm sick of being blind, I can't find the beaver anymore. Well, Let's go over there then. Yep. Nope. Beaver. Who is it? Ah, he's over there. There we go. Yeah, don't go in the water. Yep, these Dilos have to really get out of my way. Can't deal with Dilos while testing modded weapons. Now you. Brilliant. Now I only wish I would have taken berries. Now you. Come with me, we need to go get berries. But first. Well, I'm sure this turtle will be solving this by itself. Should be tank enough. Fly away. Downland, meadow berries. There we go. Half a stack should be more than sufficient. You, fly back over. Oh, come on, don't turn me over and come from half a stack of freaking meadow berries. I don't know, wait, I picked up stuff with you before, didn't I? Yeah, of course. We do not need extra weight from this, or extra weight from... Oh, damn. Ah, I'm gonna have to quickly collect a meter. And he still can't fly, of course. Ah, yes, he can. Stuck in the wall. Let's have a look here. Look, here's even some meat for you. Oh, yeah, such a big batter. Let's land here. Let's not get into the problem with these guys. You should be very hungry, according to the mod. So, you get half of these. So you're gonna go get your friend in a minute. Look at this. This is actually... This is brilliant. I have found a new favorite mod to play around with. Oh, oh no, 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 no. No, 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 no. Anybody else? Any other Dilo? No. Let's go get the guy's saddle. Enough proto castroides. Castroides? Castroides. A saddle for this guy. Yep. Saddle, saddle, saddle. Castroides, Stego, Terrodon, Dodecoros, Castroides. Because Castroides is one of the two things I really wanted to get, which I will get now. Other thing is, I'm gonna as well get his friend, tame the buck, then I'm gonna go around. He's already finished! That was so fast. Let's see, you, how heavy are you? Ah, you can be like this for now. I've put you a saddle! Let's see. Take your new saddle. Well, all I'm gonna do is go find his friend, tame his friend up just the same way, just as quickly. And then, are you following me? No, you're following, not following me, you should follow me. Follow one. You followed? Yes, that's it. Tame the other guy up as well, put the boss in yonder boat, drive back home to the island, where I have more things to show you. Be right back. And we're back, and I found not just one extra castroides, I have found two beavers. And one of them is awesomely colored. It looks like a skunk. This one I like. Plus it's the highest level out of all of them. Which is good. I can collect wood at a decent rate. Eureka. But the main reason I brought you back, I wanted to show you how funny it is to try to navigate this big wooden box. This should be K-mode. K-mode allows me to go forward. Let's go into... None came on. This is the view from right behind the boat. Or third person camera. So have a look at first, shall we? But now, I can see the buttocks of my castroides. And apparently I can shoot my gun from here. So I'll make my boat go left and right. And the poop flings off the raft. No, I shoot you. Anyway, let's have a look. As you see, this is how it is. Going forward, let's see, then I'm gonna have to go a bit more in this direction only to evade that rock. Yeah, a bit more in this direction. Yeah, now we go forward a bit. Now we have to go a bit more to this way. And, ooh, I did not go enough, a lot more into this way. Yeah. This is better. That's too much a bit. And this is how it's like to navigate this raft at the moment. So, now, what I was saying, I gotta go back to base because I have a little surprise to show you. Actually, the title should reveal it already. I've built a house. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna head back home. Look for the Dodecoros on the way, because collecting rock has become the bane of my existence in the last while. And then I will meet you back at the new house right after a little montage of how I built it. I will see you in a minute. ¶¶ I've put all the believers back home after some major disasters, pretty much. This guy... No. Was it this guy? Yeah, this guy, and this guy got stuck on a rock and glitched out of my awesome raft. As well as... Not this one, but my other pterodon. On the other hand, I as well found something else when looking at the ruin. I found... a lizard guy. A Theranosaurus. A herbivore X. And this guy looks really small for some reason when you're standing right in front of it, but... Let's put a saddle on it. All of a sudden it feels a lot bigger. As well, it looks a lot bigger. Maybe it's just because it, compared to its head, the player is kind of tiny. But anyway, the thing I want to show you before. I has made the house you have seen in the montage. Hope you liked the montage. If you did, please leave a like. And here is one house by night. As you see, it is fully illuminated, except for this side, which I still have to figure out the outside lighting, how I want to lay it out. But I will get there. Oh yeah, here's an Anki which is trapped in a tree which I need a Quetzal to untrap. I have a landing platform area right up here for pterodons or other specimens. I do not... You know what? Let's take the list away down then. Instead of taking the way back in. We have a little front porch area right here with a chest I still have to remove in front of a door. Only reason this chest is there because I was using it for moving stuff in and out. Here we have a little outlook area, which I still have to decorate a bit. Sticking some standing torches in the corners. Not quite sure what else yet, but one or two other small things still. Then we go over here. And... there, yeah, there we go. There's a ramp. Now this area is a bit dark because I still have to figure out the lighting, like I said. We have a couple of beer barrels for decorative purposes and for usage in the future, but not for now. Then we have a few campfires here for cooking food for now. As I don't have an industrial grill yet, benches to sit and wait for the campfires. Opens. It opens automatically because S plus. Now, as you see here, we have so many torches that depending on where you stand, you can actually get warm. Here. Everything is nice and lit up. I still have to think what to do with this big empty open bottom area here. I mean, I know I'm going to use this area where I have my spark bins and all this as a sort of kitchen area. Even got another beer barrel here underneath the thing. I thought that would look nice and as an aesthetical element. I have my little recipe closet here. I have a few other things. Then we have a ramp going here, down here. I'm probably gonna have to add a little bit more of light, but I'm not sure how to do it, because I could either put a standing torch here where this trike is, and this trike is in here because it's become my inside transport trike. That's why I wait. Got this huge glass window, so even if I want to try to jump out of it, I can't really. Am I trapped behind here? Yeah, there we go. We're back out. We have all sort of different workstations around here. Huge ramp. All the storage one could imagine. And that just on this floor. And I still have a lot of filling in to do, let's be honest. Industrial krill needs to come in here. A lot of other shit. So look what we got here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 smelters. We have a total of 8 mortar and pestles on tables because, yeah, better. We have a way down to the beach, which I do not want to use because getting up there, sir. We have a fabricator, which right now does not have anything in. We have a normal smithy. An S plus smithy, which is pretty much the same thing as a normal smithy, but, well, why not add it anyway? An S plus crafting station. That allows you to build all the things from the mod of S plus, all the metal parts, glass parts, wood parts, anything and everything pretty much. As long as you have the engram size. Here we have a panel workstation. Yeah, this looks like the panel workstation. Yeah, panel workstation. That allows me to switch solar panels once I get down to putting electricity in this thing, house, place. Here we have an upgrade station. This allows me to pretty much upgrade. Take any item, throw it in there, and try to upgrade. Let's see. For example, upgrading this. What would this cost me? I don't know, I'm guessing the same it requires to repair because it's showing me the requirements. So I'm guessing wood, head, metal. I should test this out at some point soon. Maybe next episode. And then we have these two things which come with the seed bank mod. Oh, what's it called? Magical crop plots or something like that. Can't remember the exact name right now. These magical platforms are floating platforms which I might actually use in the future. And we have the possibility of smithing all sorts of things, which I cannot do because I did not learn the engrams yet. But that's mainly not to get my brain confused with too many unlearned and too many learned engrams at once. And this thing is a real beauty. So kill the vending machine. Gives you kibble, especially early in the game when you don't have it yet. I mean, it's not the best kibble mod out there, but I like it. Plus, it's stylistically quite nice in the corner with the kitchen, I think. Anyway, another thing, I put up one of these which I wanted to still install quickly while I have you guys here. And then I'll go up and show you the top floor. This is actually very small. That's nice, what could I... This is pretty much a meat spoiler. What it does is exactly what it describes. It takes the meat and it spoils it. God, there's a pterodon flying around it. And I don't know why I have the feeling this would be more something likely in the kitchen. But that's mainly because it looks like the mini grill that I'm thinking that probably. Yeah, this looks like a great place. There we go. Whoa. That thing does music. Let me turn that off. I'll be right back. And I'm back. I figured out I have to turn off the spoiler. Whoa. I'm burning! This is too warm here. Apparently I'm too warm at that specific spot. Well, anyway, we'll get it up there in a second. I figured out what's wrong with the meat spoiler. When it's on, it plays music for some reason. So from now on, I'm only going to play that when I'm not recording. Up here we have the beautiful fireplace, which right now everything's burning for some reason. We have our little bedroom here, area here, because, well, it's all I need with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bookshelves, a couple of maps, some more storage, and I want to get out of this house because it's apparently very, very warm in here with all these torches. So I might look into changing them out for electric lights in the near future. But first, let's go cool ourselves down now that we've bought. Well, anyway, that's the new house. It is mainly structure build, lot of lighting. Probably I'm going to have to change now that I figured out that it's going to be too warm in there. That's something for another episode to do electrics. But it has the main areas, crafting areas, bedroom area, and it has so much storage that you could store half the island in there. Especially because of the stacking mods. We've got ourselves some new beavers. I mean, I wanted really to get into Dickerous, but that's mainly because I had to collect so much stone there. And we found this guy, which, well, the main reason I tamed him because I didn't tame one of these yet, and I would want to test it out actually. And apparently he does not like to be rided. Can I got anything here to slap? What happens if I slap this? Ooh, whoa! Okay, he just collected so much fiber. Apparently he's overweight already. Do you have no weight or something? Whoa. I collect a lot of modded magical essence things. We don't need this wood. This wood is the only reason you're heavy. This can go away. This can go away. And I don't need fiber for now, so this can go away. These I'm going to keep because I'm going to work on this very soon. But yeah. I'd really like to test this guy out and find him. Can he jump? No. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go back. Oh, actually, I want to see this quickly still before I go. There is a teleport mod in here somewhere. Teleport pass. What do I require for building these guys? Because traveling with the rafters actually kind of fun at first, but then gets very quickly. This is actually not so hard to organize. The only thing I see as a problem for organization is electronics. I'm gonna see if I can get some of these done for next episode. But anyway, I think we should call this a day here. I hope you all have a nice day. I hope you all liked montage, new house, new beavers. This guy, and I do admit this guy does kind of fun. Bit slow, but kind of fun. Anyway, like the video, like to subscribe for more. Hope you all have a nice day, and bye bye.